Normally, creating custom icons on iPhone is pretty tedious, but in the shortcut I'm about to show you, you can select multiple apps and automatically custom icons will be added to the home screen and you don't have to do anything. It's just gonna happen right here in the background and now you can try multiple icon packs easily and it won't take hours of work. Or maybe you wanna wake up to a new wallpaper every morning or just click the action button to try a new image. Well, I'm gonna give you a shortcut that automates that too. Let's actually start with that automatic wallpaper shortcut. You'll be able to download this shortcut in the video description below. And I used to have a shortcut they used Unsplash, but they've changed their API and you can't just pull images via shortcuts anymore. So I've created a new one using the Pexels API. And Pexels is a royalty-free image library and you can pull high-quality images randomly based on search terms. Again, you can download this below, but you do need to specify what wallpaper you want to change when you run this shortcut. So in this final action where it says Set Wallpaper 7, be sure to tap that. Choose your lock screen wallpaper combination that you want to change. I do my default, not one attached to a focus mode. And you can also choose lock screen and home screen, one or the other, and whether or not you want the home screen version of it to be blurred. Also, turn off the show preview. This way it happens automatically. Now, this is using my personal API, which you can get one for free if you'd like. Just go to pexels.com and then you can access their image and video API, create a free account, and you would just paste your API key there instead of mine. Now, whenever I run this shortcut and I mapped it to the action button, it's gonna pull a new image based on our search term and set it as our wallpaper automatically. Now, I have mountains as the search term here, but if you want, you can change what is searched for by replacing the word mountains. For instance, I can change that word to ocean, hit done, and now when I press the action button and it runs that shortcut, it should pull an image about oceans. I don't really care for that jellyfish. Let me try one more time. And there we have a nice image. Now, if you wanted to wake up to a new wallpaper every day, you can have this shortcut run automatically at a time of day by going to the Automations tab here, click the plus button, we'll say time of day, let's choose something like 6:24 a.m. We want this to run immediately, no confirmation or show and run, and then we can just choose new blank automation, run shortcut, and then choose our random wallpaper Pexel shortcut, and then every day you're going to wake up to a new wallpaper image on your iPhone. Now I'm also going to include another version of this shortcut, and this one actually starts with a menu prompt, and you can add search terms here if you would like. There's a text block under each search terms, then whichever you select, it will automatically insert it into that Pexels URL, so this way you can actually decide what you want to search for when you run the shortcut. I'm going to use this search version of the shortcut now on the action button, and now whenever I activate it, you'll see the menu pop up first. I can choose something like desert. Then it'll pull a random desert image from Pexels and boom, I have a wallpaper with a desert. I can run it again, search for beach, and it will pull an image based on that search term. And again, you can add to that menu on your own and add your own search terms as well. And one that I really like to do is actually gradient. That provides usually just a nice subtle wallpaper if you want to go for simplicity. That was more of a sunset than an actual abstract gradient, but you get the idea. Fun way to just play around with trying new wallpapers at the spur of the moment or scheduling it every morning. I'm gonna go back to my mountains wallpapers. That's kind of my favorite. Yeah, we'll go with that. Now, the only way I was able to build this shortcut is because I have a custom GPT that's available to members of my community, which you can join at create.beard.fm. There's actually almost 750 people a part of the community right now. And when you join, you'll get immediate access to my Shortcuts GPT. This is a GPT that I've been training, and I've now added the Pexels API, so you can ask it to help you build shortcuts that you want. And it has been an incredible resource when I'm trying to build just shortcuts for you guys for these videos. Almost 200 people are already supporting the channel through the community, which thank you all for doing that. That's amazing. And you also get access to the Shortcuts requests, which I know there's a ton of requests there. These are specifically from the paying members, which I prioritize. And the next Shortcuts request video is coming very soon, so keep the requests coming. You can leave comments down below this video, but join the community. I'm really trying to focus on the priority requests there. And again, you can join the community and support the channel by going to create.beard.fm. All right, back to building the shortcuts. Now, in recent iOS versions, you've been able to use custom icon packs that don't have to open shortcuts before actually opening the app. So even with this camera custom icon, you just tap it and it opens the camera. It won't show badges for notifications, but that's fine with me. I usually don't like having badges on there anyway, but creating these custom icons for apps is usually pretty painstaking. Typically what it takes is creating a shortcut that actually opens that app with a single action, open app. You choose the app here, and when you add it to the home screen, you can choose a custom image file. Super laborious process, and I'm going to show you how you can shortcut, pun intended, that entire process. Now this does take a couple steps to set up at first, but then you'll be able to use custom icon packs super fast. The first thing is, I've created a shortcut here which you can download below, and what this does is it creates a folder in your Shortcuts app with all the apps in this list. You can add your own apps if you want. This way, you have a starting spot. You're not having to create all these shortcuts from scratch. And all these shortcuts will be added to that folder. I'm calling it the App Icons folder. So download this shortcut, run the shortcut once. Again, I have all the apps selected initially. If there are some you don't want to include, like Kindle or 1Password, you can uncheck those. But once you do that and hit Done, Shortcuts is going to create a bunch of shortcuts. Now, some of these have a number one after it because I've already created shortcuts with that name, but this is going to save you a bunch of time because it's just going to do it automatically. And then you'll have a folder called App Icons ready to go. It's a lot of apps. I was trying to be thorough to cover all the ones people might use. Now, the one thing you'll have to do, and this will be tedious, is you will have to go into each shortcut with the app name, add the Open App action, and then choose the specific app. Now, you don't have to do this for all of them. You can just choose the apps that you want to create custom icons for, but you're only going to have to do this once, and I'll show you why in a second. Now, if you wanted to, you could expedite this process by going to Shortcuts on your Mac, which should sync over iCloud, and here you can just copy that Open App action, go into one of the other shortcuts you made, Command-V to paste that action, and then choose the other app. This should take you just a few minutes, especially if you're doing it on a Mac. But once you've added all those Open App actions to that one folder, we're going to call it App Icons, and that's going to be important in a second, you'll be done with this part of the process. The rest of it, much easier. So we have our App Icons folder or database. Now the next thing you're going to do is actually download this shortcut that I'll have below. It's called Add App Icons to Home Screen. And what this action does, you actually choose a folder in your Files app, like where you might have some icon packs saved. Then this next action says Get Shortcuts From. And here's the magic. You're going to choose that App Icon folder that was just created, and it's going to get all the shortcuts. It's going to allow you to choose which ones you want to create custom icons for. It's going to repeat the process with every icon, and then it's going to pull the icon images from the folder you specified and automatically add it to your home screen with that custom image. So, for instance, when I run this shortcut, it's going to ask me to choose a file folder. So let's say I have this entire icon pack here. This is the one I want to choose. I just tap Open. I click Done. Now I can choose what apps I want to create icons for. Let's do something like Slack, YouTube, Wallet, and Threads. Then when I hit Done, this shortcut is automatically going to add each of those icons to an additional home screen with the custom images from that file. That happened in real time. I didn't have to do anything once I ran the shortcut. You can run the same shortcut, choose a different folder. I'm going to go back and you see I have several style icons here. I'm going to go to my green select folder. This has a bunch of green tinted icons. I'm going to click Open, hit Done. And now I'll choose a couple other ones. Let's do Apple Maps, Slack, YouTube, Wallet again. And now when I hit Done, it's automatically going to add those icons to my home screen using the different icon pack that was saved in my files. And now you can quickly create multiple home screens with different icon packs with one shortcut. It takes a little setup, but it is pretty sweet. I'll actually include a link to this iPhone OS One icon pack. This one is free to download at the link below. And if you choose that folder, I'll select Messages or some of those original YouTube and Apple Maps. And now it's going to run and add those original style icons to my home screen. And again, I don't have to change anything about the shortcut. I just chose a different folder in that first action. Also, I'll put a link to these original iPhone icons if you'd like those. These Dark Notion style icons, which you're going to see in the next few shortcuts, that's actually from digitalminimalist.com. I'll be using their wallpaper packs to go along with the icons. And these are the Notion style icons that I'm using that you see on my screen right now. Oh, and one other very important point on this shortcut. In order for it to work and pull those custom images for your icons, this shortcut is basically looking for a file with the exact name of the shortcut for that app. So in your App Icons folder that you created before, pay attention to the names of the apps that you have here. So if you called it Messages, Podcast, Blue Sky, and when you have an icon pack that you've downloaded to Files, the icon for that app needs to exactly match that name. And it is case sensitive. So here in this icon pack file folder, you'll see here I have Apple Maps, Apple Music, Books, all of that matching the exact name of the shortcut. And for those Notion style icons, I had to make sure that all the names were exact. Again, Blue Sky, Books, Camera, capital C, all of it has to match exactly the name of your shortcut, because that shortcut is just looking for a file name and exactly match the name of the shortcut that you have over here in your app icon folder. Now you can quickly create multiple home screens with different themes. And what I've done is I've actually attached a couple focus modes to the different icon packs and wallpapers. So now I can go into my dark mode focus, and this is what my phone looks like. It's those Notion style dark icons, and I'm using two widgets from the app called Widgie. Widgie is actually a new app to me. I had never used it before, but you can actually download custom widgets like from that digitalminimalist.com website. And you can even adjust the look of some of the widgets, especially in light and dark mode, which was helpful to kind of make these themes. So this is my dark mode wallpaper. And I also created a light mode focus mode. And the light mode now has lighter icons, white widgets here. Unfortunately, you can't change the dock icons by changing focus modes, which is really unfortunate. So those you would have to change manually. But now I can go from light mode to dark mode. And I even created a shortcut right here that goes between my light mode and dark mode themes. So I can just tap this icon in the bottom right and switch between an entirely customized icon and widget pack, light mode and dark mode. So how do you set all that up with the button and the icons and the focus modes and all that? Well, the first thing you want to do is go over to your settings. I'm going to go back to the main settings screen and then go down to focus. Now I have a bunch of focus modes, but maybe you want to dedicate a couple specifically for these themes. So I created a dark mode focus and a light mode focus. You don't have to do anything with the people or apps. You can just allow them all to come through, which if you're unfamiliar with focus modes, I'm going to do an entire deep dive into how to set these up. So be sure to subscribe to the channel because that's going to be coming soon. But I'm going to change the setting so it still lets notifications through like normal. And then right here, you can choose a lock screen wallpaper and home screen wallpaper and setup that just activates when this focus mode is live. So let's start from scratch just to show you step by step. Let's say you don't have any focus modes. All you have is a couple home screens. Maybe you got a bunch of apps. Well, what you want to do is drag an icon to a new home screen, and there you can start customizing it. So I'm going to take one of these icons. This can also just be an app. Drag it all the way to the right side of the screen and just drop it anywhere for right now. Then what you can do is you see these dots at the bottom. When you tap that, you'll see all the different home screens that you've designed or created. You'll see, look, there's my dark mode home screen. There's my light mode home screen. And even the home screen I was just messing with the different icons, I can uncheck that home screen. And now it will just show this new home screen and my main home screen. Now, let's say I wanted to add a bunch of app icons in this dark style. Well, I'm going to go back to the shortcut. Let me run this again. I'll choose the folder with those dark mode icons. That's under the Notion style icons, iOS Black. I'll tap open. Then I choose some apps that I want to add to that home screen. We'll do podcasts, reminders, camera, Apple Maps, YouTube wallet, so on and so forth. And when I tap done, it's going to add all those new icons to that home screen that I had just created. Now, if you'd like, you can add some widgets to this home screen. I can tap edit, add widget. Again, that Widgie app is really nice for creating widgets that will match the theme you're going for, but I'll just choose a dark Fantastic Owl widget. And let's say we're done with this home screen. Well, I'm actually going to tap and hold one more time. Tap the dots at the bottom and just hide this home screen. I still created it. It's safe and sound, but now I don't have to worry about it messing up my main working mode. And this is how I typically use my iPhone. One home screen, app library right off to the side. Now, what you'll want to do is create a lock screen home screen pair that will match that home screen. So I'm going to swipe down to the lock screen, tap and hold, and then swipe all the way over. You see, I already created my dark and light mode screens there, but I'm going to go all the way to the right and let's create a new lock screen wallpaper. I'm going to choose photos, and you'll see here, these are some of the wallpapers from that Digital Minimalist website. I have some from Basic Apple Guy, and I have a bunch more saved in my files. But let's choose one here with Paul Atreides there standing on the mountain. That'll be the lock screen. You can add some lock screen widgets if you want, change the font of the clock. Let's add it, and you can customize the preview down here, whether or not you want the home screen to actually be blurred. So we'll hit done, and now we've created a new pair. But it's not really attached to anything. So when you swipe up, it still goes to that main grid of icons that I have for my main home screen. So I'm gonna leave that, go back to my normal setup here, and now let's create a focus mode that specifically uses that lock screen and home screen combination with those custom app icons. So I'm gonna go back to the settings app, and now I'm gonna choose one of these focus modes or create one if you don't have the maximum like I do. And let's say you created this one called dark mode. Well, now I can scroll down. I'm gonna tap choose here on the lock screen, and you'll see all the lock screens you've created. And there's our lock screen with Paul Atreides on the mountain. That's the combination of lock and home screen that we want. So we're going to choose that. And then the second part, you can choose what home screens you want to be active when this focus mode is enabled. And so you'll see right now they're all unchecked. So I'm going to go down and just check the home screen that we created together a few moments ago. I'll hit done, and that's all we really need to do. Focus modes are really powerful though. If you want to do more exploring, you can actually change your watch face based on focus mode, set this focus mode on a schedule. So if you want this to be active every day at sunset, and focus filters are incredibly powerful too, where you can even do things like showing a Safari tab group during this focus mode, certain calendar sets. That's what I use in Fantastical. Only show certain mail accounts. It's incredible. Focus modes undefeated when it comes to iPhone. But if you just want to do the custom lock and home screen, we've done it. And now we have our dark focus mode. And so what happens? We go home, we're in our normal home screen, normal workday. Now we can activate a focus mode, which you can do here in the control center. Tap dark mode here and look at everything that just changed. There's the home screen we created with our custom app icons, a custom widget. If I swipe down to see the lock screen, there's Paul Atreides on the mountain. And now we've created a special dark mode focus mode with custom icons, lock screen, and wallpaper. Now I'm going to go back to the home screen that I created before, where I had that little icon down here which switches between my dark mode and light mode, lock screen, and home screen. Now to do that, this is actually another shortcut. And all that's happening is it's switching between two different focus modes and then enabling or disabling dark mode. So let's go back to shortcuts, and I'll share a link to these dark mode, light mode shortcuts below. You'll have to go in there and choose your focus modes, but for this dark mode shortcut, simple two-action shortcuts. It makes the appearance of the iPhone go into dark mode, and it turns my dark mode focus mode on until I manually turn it off. And if you want to add those actions manually yourself, just search for focus, and you can set focus right here. That's the action that I used in this second part. The top action, that one's actually called appearance, and you can choose the set appearance action here to set your system-wide light mode or dark mode. And then all I did was add this shortcut to my home screen, and that's what these shortcuts are right here. This is my dark mode shortcut. This is one of the custom icons I used from that pack. And this dark mode shortcut is the one I just showed you, which goes back to my dark mode focus. All right, I know that was a little complicated, and I did want to put a bunch of other shortcuts in this video because that's already kind of time consuming. But if you have any questions about these shortcuts that lets you create custom icon packs quickly, or working with focus modes, custom lock and home screens, and all of that, drop them in the comments below. I'm going to do a long, in-depth video on focus modes specifically, how I use them and set them up, and all the filters available even with third-party apps. So be sure to subscribe to the channel for that, hit that like button, and if you have any questions on focus mode specifically, drop them in the comments below because I'll try to answer them all in the next video. And again, if you have special shortcuts requests, I know there's lots of requests still outstanding even for my priority requests. So be on the lookout. I'm getting that video out soon, but you can go to create.beard.fm to join the community for free. And then if you support with $5 a month, you can get access to my shortcuts GPT that I've been training and priority shortcuts requests, in addition to my shortcuts database and all of that. If you want to see the last shortcuts request video, which I had a ton, and some people were asking for that big movie shortcuts that I made to include TV shows, well, spoiler, I already did it. It's already in the membership community if you want to join that, but you can check out the video right up here. And if you want to customize your phone even more, I did videos on the custom control center apps you can use right now to totally go crazy and create multiple control center pages and actually make it useful. You can check out that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.